name's Tara, and we're going to be doing a little bit of yoga postures with a focus on building strength today in the core, and some stretching and lengthening, opening your bodies, growing taller, and we'll do some relaxation, some meditation, mindfulness activity that you can do at home, and some breathing. So I hope you enjoy it. Come on up to standing. First, just take a deep breath in, raising the arms up. And then just bring the hands down through the center. Great. And then working with balance, if you have a yoga mat, start at the back of your mat. And you're just going to walk one foot in front of the other. Just like you're on a tightrope. You can look straight ahead or out and down. See if you can just walk backwards. Now, if you feel like this is a little bit easy, then close your eyes this time and just walking one foot in front of the other. That's not as easy as you think. And then walking backwards. Great. And we'll take another balancing pose, tree pose. You're going to pick up your right foot, and you can put that foot below your knee or bring it up really high. Press your foot to your thigh, turn the knee out, bring the hands into prayer. Press the hands strongly together and see if you can be steady. Now again, if this is a little bit easy, you might raise your arms up. And the real challenge is actually looking up. That'll make it even a little bit more tricky. Also bring your arms out to the side, and if you'd like, you could take your hands into the back and make them in a prayer position. Open the chest, drop the shoulders, and stay steady. Good. From here, we'll come into dancer pose. Take your right hand to your heel, your ankle, press the foot to hand, and open the chest. And again, if you can, look up. And then to be balanced on both sides, take a deep breath in again. Maybe if you can, in through the nose. Big breath, out through the mouth. Good. Pick up the left foot, and maybe that foot just goes below the knee, or maybe you can pick your foot up, bring it up really high. Press the foot strongly, steady that supporting leg, bring the hands into prayer, tree pose. So again, if you'd like to try a few variations, you can reach up, you can even look up. Maybe bring your arms out to the side. Or again, take the hands up the back, so you're making a little prayer position, rolling your shoulders back, opening your chest and being able to take a more expansive breath. Good. From here, reach for your left ankle and work with balance, focus, steadiness, concentration. Open this bow like a bow and arrow. Look up. Good. Now just warming up the body, come down onto all fours. I'll go sideways to show you, and we'll take some cat-cow. So you drop your belly down, you look up, and then press the floor away, stretching like a cat. And we're using the breath to release any tension. So you drop the belly down, look up, and then exhale, even a bit of a press the floor away. And then take a few little circles. Just a bit of a circling cat or a dancing cat, one way, then the other. Might even like to do a bit of a disco cat, wiggle your tail. Good. From here, press into your hands, and we're actually going to flip them back to face us, fingers towards you. So flip them back. Just stretch out the back of the arms, and then press into your toes. up into dog pose. Back to dog pose, take a little walk here, a bit of a pedal, and then raise your left leg all the way up to the sky, three-legged dog. Draw the knee in, bring your foot all the way forward so you create a nice right angle here, strong legs, and then see if you can be strong and steady. Bring the hands behind the head, and again that circle. Taking ourselves off balance to bring a little bit more balance. Get some more mobility in the upper body. Build strength. Good. And then create that aeroplane. Spread your wings and lean forwards. Good. Bring the hands down. And step your right foot in. Take a big breath in. And we're going to bend the knees and come into chair pose. And a little twist. Twists are good for wringing out tension. Bring the hands to the heart. And then just take a little twist. Maybe you can hook your elbow to your knee. And really use that exhalation to release any stiffness, heaviness, any worries, any anxiety. Twist to the other side.
You could say was it
good. And then we'll bring our hands back down to the floor, stepping back, press into those hands, strong arms, lift your foot up to the sky. Draw the knee in. This time turn the back foot in. So you're turning that back heel in and you're coming up to warrior one. Body to the front. Strong like a warrior. Great. Turn to the side. Look down your middle finger. Warrior two. And then we'll turn up the right palm and reverse warrior. Stretching the side seams of the body. Good. Bring yourself forwards. Turn your fingers again to face you. Place them on the floor and see if you can lift up and open. Breathe big into the whole body. And we create a really big balancing shape. Walk your hands forwards, your right hand, or you can even use a block if you have something handy. You take that out in front, turn the toes to the side. Bring your hand on the hip, the half moon pose, and maybe raise your arm up. You can keep your gaze to the floor. And if you really want to build some strength today, see if you can balance like you're holding a big ball. Great. Bring the feet back. Fold in half like a ragdoll. You can always have a little swing here or a sway. Try and plug your knees into your armpits and just hang. Good. Let's go to the other side. Raise the left leg to the sky. Draw the knee in. Stepping forwards. Turn. turn the back heel in and come up to your strong warrior. Bend deep. Turning to the side, warrior two. You look down your middle finger and you look like a fierce warrior, not a warrior. Relax your eyebrows, smile. Turn up the left palm, reverse. Then we're just going to spin those fingers. Place your hand to the floor. Or if you can't reach, you just take a block, or you could rest your elbow on your knee and open up this shape. Good. From here, we're going to transition again into that really big pose, the half moon. So if you've got a block, you can take the block out or your fingers out. You hop that right foot in and then very carefully lift it up. Shoot the toes to the sky, your navel to the side, strong legs, and then lift up. Now if it's a little bit challenging, keep your gaze down to the floor. Really building strength, focus, and concentration in this pose. And then if you're feeling like you've got all that, maybe you can hold that big beach ball and fly. Good. And let's come on down onto the knees. And we're just going to take our knees out wide, our big toes touch. Walk your hands forwards and drop down into the child's pose. Resting the head and again starting to tune into your breath, a smooth, steady, even breath. Deepening the breath. And then just walking your hands over to the left. So we're stretching the side body, the skin, drawing back, release any heaviness. To the other side. Get rid of those and press into the hands, draw back. Good. Now we're going to have a little bit of fun building some strength in your core, so around the belly, which really supports you and makes you feel strong and motivated. So bring the hands down to the ground and we're going to press back to our plank. So see if you can hold this pose. From here, look forwards, jump the feet in. It's a little bit like a frog into Malasana. It's a monkey pose. Some of you will be able to get your heels down on the ground. You can even have a little swish like this just to get into the hips. Press your elbows to the knees and open up the hips, keeping your body flexible and open. And if this is a bit challenging, you've got something handy like a block or a book, you can actually just sit. You could sit on that block. So you just have to find what works for your body. And if something doesn't feel right, make sure you make some adjustments. And then we'll bring the hands back down and jump back to plank. Good. We'll do a couple of these. Jump in again, monkey pose. Keep breathing big, especially if this gets a little bit challenging. Really tune into the breath. Bring the hands down, jump back, and then jump back in. One more monkey, bit of a swish here. Bring the hands into prayer, ground down through your feet. So really grounding, anchoring pose as well. A few deep breaths here. Something handy, like just a little object, or go and grab one. You could use a 20-cent coin, you could use a Lego man, you could use anything that you can find around your house, even a pen. So take that object, bring it out in front, and come back to your plank pose. Now pick up your object, or you can pretend you've got something in your hand, thread it through to the other side, and then back to plank. Take the left hand, pick up your object, 20-cent coin, Lego man, pen, toy, anything. Thread it through as far as you can to the other side. Put it down, come back. Let's do two more. Pick up that. It's a bit of a challenge, plank challenge. Thread it through. Switch. Pick it up. Wave it around. Thread it through as far as you can. And then come back and we'll lower down. And this time we'll just press up into our forearms, pressing up into the Sphinx pose. So feeling the strength in your back body lift up. You can always look forwards or you can look down. Good. And then maybe come up a little bit higher. You can bring your thumbs under the armpits, press up a baby cobra. Or if this feels good for your spine, come up a little bit further. Or roll the shoulders down the back. Stretch out through your toes and lift all the way up. And you can look forwards, or again, you might even just look up if that feels good. This pose really supports your kidneys. And it also is one of the feel-good poses, back bends. They wake us up. Good. And then we'll draw back, take the knees out wide again, the big toes touch. Draw back into that child's pose. Good. And then bring your legs out in front, and I'll come on the side to show you. We're going to come into a little bit of a half boat. So you try and stack your calves in line with the floor. You sit up and maybe you can reach out again, working the core. Balancing in the boat. Can you hold this boat? If you feel some wobbles or shakes, that's the body just getting stronger. Now if you feel okay here and you could lift your legs up and make like the letter B, come into full boat, and then bring it back down, and then give yourself a hug for coming to yoga today. And we're going to do a little bit of a rock and roll. This is nice for your spine, it's a bit of fun. So from that boat pose, you're going to rock back into the snail pose. We flip over and then rock back to the boat. Hold that boat. Make sure there's nothing behind you. Swing back. And then come back up. Let's do another one. Now if you can come up to that full boat, you can lift up, it's your choice. One more, back to boat, feeling this a little bit of into the belly. Now the next time I change, rock back and roll up to Nalasana, the monkey. We'll do a couple of those, roll back and monkey pose, roll back, monkey pose. One more just because it's fun. Monkey pose. Great. Now, sitting back down. Just take the legs out in front. A little bit of a wriggle so you can feel your sit bones. Bring the fingers forwards. Drop your shoulders and have good posture. So when you lift your chest, you sit up tall. You have more energy. Everything works more efficiently. Good. Now, take your right hand. If you can do this, pat your head, rub your belly, you'll be able to do these poses because it's going to get a little bit twisty and funky. Take the right hand, pick up your right foot with the same arm, draw the toes back and give your hip a little rock. It's called rock your baby. And I know some of you can probably take your telephone and talk on your telephone, touch a big toe to your nose. You can try that if you like. Good. Press that foot like the tree pose and raise your right arm up. This is great for your digestion, your metabolism, and again, releasing anything you're holding in your body at the moment. Reach over, see if you can catch little toe, ankle or shin. Sometimes you can use a strap or a belt if you can't press into those fingers like a cat claw and twist, and with length fold forwards.
Draw your chin in, close your eyes.
Good, come back up, cross your arms, bit of crossing over, reach for the feet, lift up like a back bend, look up, breathe big, and then a bit of a as you fold forwards. You can bend your elbows,
maybe you can bring your nose to your knee,
maybe you can bring your forehead to your shin, but if you're up here, it's okay as well. Yoga is not about being the most flexible person, it's about being the best version you can be of yourself. Helping you feel good in your body and connected. Good. Coming back up, switch legs. Take that same arm as leg, so we're balanced on both sides. Pick up the foot and just notice, is there a difference on this side? Is there some tightness? Is this the leg that you use to kick a football or the sport that you use more often? We just notice, just become curious in your body, tuning in. And then pressing that foot to thigh, shoot your toes to the sky, raise the left arm up, stretch that side, big stretch, reach over, take your time, maybe catch your little toe, ankle, shin. And again, we're twisting and wringing, we're flossing the spine. Take your fingers, press to the floor and twist. And if you can, maybe you bend your elbows and you fall down. Good. Coming back up, cross over. It's all good. It's all this. Good for your brain. Cross over, reach your feet, look up. If you feel like you're having a little rock or a sway, a bit of a dance to this music, that's okay. Bow forwards. Good. Bring yourself back up. Now this is where we get a little bit twisty and funky. So bring your right foot in. I think that's the way I want to know, and I've tricked myself. Bring that foot. This is called Virasana. Bring that heel near your hip, but we're just going to take it out a little bit. So the foot's going back, the left leg is coming out to the side, a bit like a half fan, and you can pick yourself up and really working on flexibility here. This is where it gets twisty. Take the left hand, thread it under your right leg, lift up, and can you grab your ankle? Then you sit back down. This is a bit of a bind. Fold over, reach your arm over, and maybe you might be able to catch a big toe, look through the window. You might hold your hip, you might just stretch. But feel this really deep, getting into our side body. Now notice what you're doing with your face. Notice if you might be doing your eyebrows down or scrunching up your face. And see if you can smile or just soften here, and that will help. Good. Bring yourself back up. And we'll release that leg. And then pick up your left leg. Spin it back. Flip the toes back. So you're just really pressing that foot down, working your feet, your ankles. We spend a lot of time putting our feet in shoes, and this is a counterpose to that. Take that leg out. Bring your foot out to the sides. You're creating a big shape here, like a half fan. Take your right hand, thread it under. Can you catch your ankle, your foot, or even just your clothing? Sit back down, and then take your arm over, using your arms like levers to stretch and lengthen. Maybe again, you hold your big toe, look through the window, hold the back of your head, or just stretch long. Changing shape of our organs, nourishing internally. just going to take a breath here, learn a little humming bee or a buzzing bee breath, which creates a vibration through your body. So you're going to make a bit of a sound, like a bee, and we'll do that first. So just take a deep breath in through the nose. Senses. You're going to block off your ears and you're going to close your eyes and you're going to feel that vibration just releasing any tension you might be holding in your body, helping you really tune in and just noticing the sounds and the feelings. So take a deep breath in through the nose, block off the ears, close your eyes and create that sound like a bee. Breathe in. Here we go. To just lay down and do a little bit of work again, lengthening the spine and for the core, working the legs. So lay down and just take a moment to draw your knees in, hug your knees, and you might even like a little rock. Good, and then bring your arms out like the letter T, and we're just going to drop our knees over and hover them off the floor. Other side. Now those of you who might want to be working a little bit more dynamically or stronger, straight legs here, take them over and see if you can hover. Good, bring them back up and then over to the other side, a little hover. Good, come back to center, interlace your hands around your knee and big stretch, long spine. Then switch, press out through the feet, long spine. Good. This time make your arms like goalposts, cactus arms, and draw your knee in one at a time. Really use those muscles of the core. And then pick up your right foot, place it onto your knee. So it's like a number four shape. Flex the feet, thread the hands through, and squeeze. Squeeze the shoulders away from the ears. And if anything feels challenging again, really use your breath, especially that exhalation with a bit of a ha or a sigh sound. Maybe again even a little rock here. This rocking action is very soothing. Sides, grab your baseball glove, your ball, stack your heel over your knee and really release lower back, the hips. And then we'll reach for both heels, this pretty fun pose, full happy baby. And if you feel like again having a little rock back and forth or side to side, you can. It's a pose that reminds us to not take it all too seriously. To your belly. We're just going to do a little bit of work strengthening the back body. Turn the palms up, stretch out through your toes, see if you can lift up, fly like Superman or Wonder Woman. Reach for your feet if you can. If you can't, you just do that. that one again. If you can, catch your ankles, come up to the bow and notice how good this makes you feel. Flex your feet, lift up. Great. And again, just press up into that baby cobra or king cobra. And notice if you're feeling a little bit more alive from this yoga practice. Good. From here, another little bit of a mindfulness game, a bit of fun, some ideas that you can do at home. You can see behind me that I've got a little bit of a spider web I've built. You just get some wool and you weave wool throughout the whole room. It's lots of fun. And create a little bit like a matrix here. And the idea of this game is you have to mindfully weave in and out, just doing any movement you like. And we're going to have a little go of this today. You can set one up at home afterwards. But if you're just on your yoga mat or in your room, maybe you can imagine that you've got some spider webs that you can crawl under, go through. Try not to touch them. You might be able to leap over the top. Oh, I'm not sure. Oh, you might go back under. And I'm going to play some music for you to creep around. The first one's a little bit like an action kind of spy soundtrack. So I want you to get your spy hat on. And you're going to just move any way that this music makes you move. Maybe you'll just do some of the yoga poses you've learned, or maybe you'll just start to creep and crawl and roll and twist all around the floor. All right, let me find the song for you. Here it comes. Okay, here's the first song for you. Moving around any way you like to this music. So you might be down low, you might be getting up a little bit higher, or you might be right up doing some of those cool yoga poses. To sit and take a rest. Whatever this music makes you feel like doing, maybe some of those poses you've done before. Oh, let me find the next one. Here we go. See how this one makes you move. And maybe it's makes you a little bit more floppy or like a creature, an animal. What does it remind you of? Freeze there. And back to just a little bit of bringing ourselves back now, a little bit of calm. And I'm going to show you a little heart hand mudra. So using your hands, these mudras are used in yoga just for focus, concentration, bring our awareness in. This one is the heart mudra. You take your pointer finger, drop it in, take two fingers, the next two, bring them to your thumb, and then bring your pinky fingers out. And you're just going to bring your hands in front of your heart, relax your shoulders, closing your eyes. And really breathing in an expansive breath where you focus on this heart space. And our heart space is linked to compassion, love, courage, openness. Just see if you can just really bring your awareness to that space. Good, and then just release the hand mudra. Bring your left hand onto your heart and bring your right hand on top. And again, just closing the eyes. Just going to take a moment to practice gratitude. So thinking about three things today that you're really grateful for. And just naming them to yourself. And that might be your family members, your teachers, your house. Set yourself up in a comfortable position. So maybe if you've got a block or a blanket or something you can sit on, you can sit up a little bit higher. You're going to cross your legs, and again you might choose a little hand mudra, or I'll show you another one, bird beaks. And just turning the palms up makes you feel really open. Or if you feel a little bit nervous or anxious and you want to ground yourself, turn your hands down and place them down. Relax your shoulders, sit tall, and just tuning into your breath, that smooth, steady breath. And again, you might just close your eyes and see if you can just make your breath even. An even inhalation. And this will help steady you, ground you, make you feel more balanced physically and emotionally. And maybe you'd like to even count your breath, so maybe you can count for three, in for three, and out for three. If it helps you to put your hands on your belly, you can always just feel that breath like a balloon, expanding and contracting. And it's a fantastic technique just to really center yourself and ground yourself. Good. And then from here, you're going to set yourself up for a final resting pose. In yoga, it's called Shavasana, just a little bit of a stillness. And I'll show you a few options. Some people like to just stay seated. So you might just, again, like to stay here with a long spine and just sit, stillness. You might like to, a really fun, popular pose is legs up the wall. It's really grounding and makes you feel, again, centered and balanced, and it can help you sleep if you have a little bit of trouble at night sleeping. And the best way to get in is you get in close to your wall, get in sideways, and then just flip your legs up the wall. It's like the letter L, and you just
just rest your legs to the wall, long spine. It's also great if you have tired legs and you do lots of exercise. It helps recharge. Now, some people like to be on their belly, so I call this one the Spider-Man pose, where you just take one leg out to the side, bent, and you bend your elbow like you're climbing up a wall, like Spider-Man. Turn the head to the side and just drop down to the earth. So when we get close to the earth, it also is very grounding. Or you might like to just lay back in this neutral corpse pose. Just turn your palms up and just relax. So I'm going to give you a few seconds just to choose which pose is going to be the right pose for you. And just making yourself comfortable. A few deep breaths again, just to settle yourself. I'm going to read you a little meditation today. It's called the feather meditation. And if you have a feather at home or a leaf, it's also a really nice way to just relax. Remind you to relax your eyebrows, face, your jaw, neck. You can just brush a feather across the body as a little reminder to feel calm. Get yourself a feather. You might like to just close your eyes and then just listening to my voice as I talk you through a feather meditation. So take a deep breath in, and just this time we will do a big an audible sigh. Closing your eyes and just imagining that you are becoming feather. Feel your softness. Feel how light you are. And now the wind picks you up and you begin to float. And you start to float up and up. And you float all the way up to the treetops. And the wind carries you higher. You now are high above the treetops, rising further and further up to the sky. You float up into space. You float beyond the earth. You float past the moon and the sun. All the planets. And you float further and further away. And now you start to float in between the stars. You float past the stars. And just notice, how far can you float? Continue floating. And now you begin to just float back down to earth, slowly. And the earth looks closer and closer below you. You float down gently, further and further down, and again you pass the treetops, and finally you land softly back on the earth. Now just take a moment to wriggle your fingers and wriggle your toes and bring your awareness back to your room. Draw your knees.
hug for practicing yoga today. And then just roll into your right side. Slowly bring yourself back up to seated. And we'll take three deep breaths in. We're just going to raise the arms up. Bring the hands down through the center. Breathe in again. Fill your body with breath. And one more. Good. Bring your hands to your heart and then bowing your head to your heart. And namaste. Say namaste at the end of each yoga class, and it really means that I see the light in you and you see the light in me. And thank you for coming to yoga today. I hope you'll come back again. I hope that really sets you up for a fantastic day.